Hi everybody, welcome back to Sunshine Soap and Candle Company. I've been getting a lot of requests lately to share with you how to make an in-shower body lotion. Some of you might be wondering what exactly is that. So basically it's a thicker type cream, much like a hair conditioner, that you apply to your wet skin in the shower and you leave it to sit on your skin for a few minutes and then you rinse it off. It leaves your skin feeling moisturized and silky smooth. It's perfect to use on those days where you want the added moisture from something like a lotion, but maybe you just don't have time or desire to get out of the shower and put on your favorite lotion. In this video today, I'm going to be going over my step-by-step process and tutorial of how to put together this beautiful in-shower lotion. And if you want the full written recipe, plus a full written detailed tutorial with percentages and links to where I purchased all the ingredients to make this product, please head on over to my Patreon campaign where you can unlock this formula for just a $5 pledge. Not only will you be able to unlock today's formula, you'll be able to access 3.5 years of archive recipes all for the same $5 pledge. I post weekly tutorials and formulas complete with a full step-by-step tutorial, percentages, amounts, and sort of a blog-style post for each formula. In addition to that, there are 4 other tiers you can take a look at and take advantage of, each with their own unique benefits. We offer things like quarterly classes, live monthly hangouts, monthly gift packages, coupon codes to my favorite suppliers, and so much more. It's a great way to connect with me. It's a great way to connect with other makers. I really hope you'll make 2023 your year and head on over to my campaign and see what it's all about. I'll put the link in the description box below for you. All right, let's make some beautiful in-shower lotion. All right, so much like most lotions, this recipe is broken up into a water phase, an oil phase, and then a cool down phase. Now, what's going to make this different than a lotion you want to leave on your skin is we're going to be adding in some cationic ingredients. Those are going to be the ingredients that make your skin feel very conditioned and also give it very good rinse off. So a regular lotion isn't going to be super easy to rinse off your skin. This is going to be easier to rinse off your skin, but it's going to leave you nice and silky smooth. All right, so the first thing we're going to do is weigh off the water phase ingredients. And I have a little bit of cationic guar gum in here. It's important that this is a cationic guar gum and not a regular guar gum because the cationic charge is what's going to give this a very beautiful silky conditioning feel. So we're going to drop this into the bottom of our Pyrex. And then we're going to go ahead and weigh off some glycerin. Now, the glycerin in this formula is quite high, and we're doing that for a couple reasons. This is going to help with kind of the humectant quality. It's going to add a loads of moisture to this product, and it's going to add a little viscosity as well. All right, so once the glycerin is over the top of your guar gum, you're going to want to go ahead and give this a mix to combine. We're just combining and we're dispersing the guar gum into the glycerin and making sure that we do this first and not adding the water in directly over the top of the guar gum. This is going to help it so it doesn't clump up in your water. The guar gum is also going to act as a bit of an emulsifier and a thickener for this formula. All right. And then the next thing we're going to do is go ahead and add in some distilled water. Now back to the cationic guar gum. I did get that from makingcosmetics.com. You can get it there. So then the next thing we're going to do is go ahead and add in our water. All right, we're going to be adding in a tiny bit of water-soluble pink dye. This is the balm colorants that Brambleberry used to carry. I don't think they carry it anymore. We're just going to add in a couple drops, and then we're going to go ahead and stir in the water with our guar gum and glycerin.
Then we're just gonna go ahead and set our water phase aside. Once everything is combined, go ahead and set the water phase aside. Next, it's time to go ahead and weigh off the oil phase for this formula. So we're gonna be adding in to this beaker another beautiful cationic ingredient. This is gonna be the emulsifier that we're using today. This is BTMS 50. I got this from Brambleberry. This is gonna act as our emulsifier, but it's a cationic ingredient as well. So this is an ingredient that you find in hair conditioners a lot of the time, and anything where you just want that nice, silky, powdery finish. We're gonna go ahead and add that in. Okay. The next thing we're gonna do is add in some cetyl alcohol. Now, cetyl alcohol is a gorgeous fatty alcohol. In combination with the BTMS 50, it has a beautiful, lovely, silky skin feel and helps to rinse down the product completely off your skin, leaving it nice and silky smooth. So this is not, again, this is not a product that you would want to leave on your skin like you would a lotion. And I'll do a little product demo at the end. It doesn't sink in like a lotion does. Okay. The next thing we're going to do is go ahead and add in our oils and butters to this formula. So we're going to be using, I have some sunflower oil here. This sunflower oil has been infused with calendula, and you can use any light carrier oil that you like. I'm just trying to use up some of my oil infusions that I've had for a little while here. So we're going to go ahead and add in our sunflower oil. Okay. And then we're going to be adding in some beautiful cocoa butter. Now, cocoa butter is going to help add to the thickness of this property, the thickening properties of this formula. And cocoa butter is high in antioxidants and just a gorgeous decadent butter to use. So we're going to be adding in these little deodorized cocoa butter pastilles. I got these from Brambleberry. Perfect. And then we're going to go ahead and take our oil phase and our water phase, and we're going to go ahead and heat them up in a wide saute pan with a few inches of water, like a double boiler system. And then we're going to combine our oils and our water. All right, I'll bring you right back for the next step. All right, so my water and oil phases are now both heated up and warmed through and melted down. The BTMS 50 likes to set up quickly, so you have to kind of work fast here. They're both sitting right around 170 degrees. So we're going to go ahead and start by pouring our water phase ingredients into our oil phase ingredients. And then I'm going to use the stick blender to combine the two phases together into a nice emulsification. Okay, right away you can see this gorgeous light pink, thick, beautiful emulsion. I'm going to go ahead and emulsify this for a few minutes and then I'll bring you back for the next step. All right, so it's been completely blended up and it's fully emulsified now, but it's still quite thin because it is very warm still. However, it is cool enough to go ahead and add in our cool down phase ingredients. We're sitting right around 140 degrees. Now, you're gonna notice this texture has a very bouncy kind of texture, and that is due to the lovely cationic guar gum that kind of gives it a gel cream kind of texture. And we're gonna go ahead and add in our fragrance oil. So we're using beautiful champagne toast fragrance oil. I picked up this one from Windy Point. However, there are probably lots of places to get this champagne toast. I think it's a Bath & Body Works dupe. However, to me, this one does not smell like the Bath & Body Works one. This one smells like a beautiful kind of bubbly, effervescent, tangerine, kind of berries and tangerine fragrance. It smells really good. and it's and you can smell the bubbles in it. And then we're gonna go ahead and add in our optiphen preservative. Now we're adding this in because it is a broad spectrum preservative and this has a high oil content in this formula, and this is great for high oil content type formulas. Here we go. And we're gonna go ahead and give this a little stir by hand, and then we'll use the stick blender again to make sure everything is completely combined. Also, that optiphen is the 176 degrees optiphen from Brambleberry. I really like it because you can add it in at a bit of a higher temperature. You can add it in below 176 degrees Fahrenheit. All right, so we're gonna go ahead and allow this formula to cool down, and I'll bring you back when we're ready to package it up. All right, everybody, this formula has cooled down now to room temperature. It's absolutely gorgeous. It's got a beautiful texture to it. It's just kind of creamy, silky, and it's got a nice bounce to it because of that guar gum. I just really, really love the texture of this. So we're just gonna go ahead and package this up. This is a 4-ounce PET container, wide mouth. I got this from Berlin Packaging. I don't know if all of my formula is gonna fit in here, but we're gonna give it a try. And I do have a bit left over here that I'll put into another small container. We're just going to go ahead and pop the lid on. I love the beautiful pink color. Because of the champagne toast fragrance oil, if I was going to sell this, I would probably call it pink champagne and shower body lotion. And look at that gorgeous, gorgeous texture. All right, stick around for a little bit of a use demo. All right, so I'm gonna go ahead and show you how to use this. So we're just gonna use a little bit out of my container here. So assuming your skin is all wet, you're in the shower, your skin is gonna be wet. So this is what it's gonna look like. It's gonna apply on like a lotion. I'm just gonna scoop a little bit out on my spatula here. You're gonna want, you know, a pretty good amount on your skin. This is probably way more than I need, but just to kind of give you an idea. And then you just go ahead and you rub it in and you allow it to sit. So this would be, see how it's going in much like a hair conditioner? You just go ahead and you rub it onto your skin. Now for me, I like to stay out of the direct water, or you can turn the water off. And you just allow it to sit on your skin and condition and work like a lotion. I've got a little bit here too, we can go ahead and use up. And then after it has sat for 2 minutes or so, you just go ahead and rinse it off. And it's got that gorgeous, silky, kind of conditioned skin feel. And you're left with just gorgeously hydrated, nicely scented, lightly scented skin. And there you go, everybody. That is how you make a beautiful in-shower lotion. I hope you liked this video. If you did, I hope that you'll give it a thumbs up, leave a comment or question below, share this video with a friend, and don't forget to subscribe to my channel. All right, everybody, catch you on the next video. Bye, keep shining.